hit that button.
From the
studio
of the
Iconic
Governor's Comedy
Club.
This is Circling the Drain.
It's a nice day to start again.
And it certainly is a nice day to start again with the Circling the Drain podcast live on the air everywhere. Hello, you beautiful people.
Hello, you ugly people as well. Well, we gotta give everybody love, you know, I mean...
Hello, the medium people?
Hello, the moderately, not totally attractive people, but drink, whatever.
If you're happy and you know it, drink up now?
Yeah, yeah. Okay. If you're happy and you know it, try and form a sentence. And that's my life.
And
so,
since you know we can't form a sentence, you must be listening to the Circling the Drain podcast. I'm going to get this show started very quickly. My name is Ira over there, the man who stumbled over his first few sentences. It's my buddy Sean Radford.
Oh, son of a... Well, you know how that goes. All right, well, hopefully all my other jokes aren't half as terrible as the first one was, because that one sucked. But I can't tell sucky jokes on my own, so I need people to tell sucky jokes too. And on the right-hand side of the table is the royalty side of the table, and
no.
She's not here!
Oh,
she is still out of country!
The royalty tour continues.
So,
hello, everybody!
Ladies and gentlemen, back for a second time! You know her, you love her! It's Mo!
It's Mo.
Woo!
Mo on the scene.
How are you, Mo?
How's it going?
I'm wonderful this evening, gentlemen.
Great.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having me back.
Thank you for coming back.
Yeah, basically, we were like, is she coming back? Who wants to start the poll now, if she's coming or not?
I mean, she was laughing, but was she laughing at us or with us? We couldn't tell. We weren't sure.
We'll find out later today.
It was a healthy mixture of both.
There it is. We'll take them both. Any laugh's a good laugh.
And who else is in the playroom today?
Huh. Well, I mean, people do enjoy cheeseburgers, but they don't enjoy them without pickles on them.
Hey!
Hold the pickles. Apparently.
Hold the pickles.
Oh, okay. So,
well, extra pickles.
Well, you could hold some.
I don't want to hold. Oh,
I ain't holding nothing.
We'll get your wife later.
Yeah,
thank you. It's like, honey, hold the pickles.
Listen, it's cold in this studio, but it ain't that cold.
I'm allergic to
pickles.
Brine.
Pickles.
Oh, is it just brine?
Yeah.
Great.
Oh, wait, hold on.
I should have warned you before, like, last week. So did you rash out in any hives when you left the studio?
Yeah.
Well, the podiatrist was very surprised when I showed him, you know, that part of my body.
Yeehaw! Oh, man.
Ooh, wait a minute.
And it wasn't even a checkup to me.
Boy, I was here last week, and I don't even remember any of that. What is going on?
You have an immunity,
right?
You've been exposed to pickles way
true.
Too much.
Yeah. I got the horse blinders at this point. It's fine.
Not yet.
Yeah.
So today is the 6th.
The 6th of December.
It is Wednesday, December 6th.
Yeah, Wednesday.
But
whip them out.
I want to talk. Oh, God.
I don't know what them are. But
back.
Whip them out. Whatever
going back
you want.
To O&A, aren't you?
I was just saying, take something, just whip shit out.
Okay.
Whatever. Anyway, sorry.
I want to talk about tomorrow.
Okay.
Tomorrow is Thursday, December 7th.
Right.
Where three important things are happening.
Oh.
One is historical.
Okay.
One is religious.
Oh.
And one is celebratory.
Hmm.
Can anybody guess any of the dates?
V-Day.
Bingo.
Okay.
It is the Day of Remembrance, of course, when Pearl Harbor was attacked.
Gotcha.
Day that will live in infamy. That's historical.
Right.
As the great Smokey Robinson would say, tomorrow is the first night of Chinooka.
Oh!
He's got it. Wait, ding, ding, ding. Okay. Hold on. No, it won't come out right now. There you go. That's two. Can anybody guess the celebratory one? Won't.
We're not celebrating Hanukkah. We're just
observing. We are.
We're just observing. Yes. We're like, it's early this year, isn't
it? As the Jew in the room. Yeah.
Yeah. That's here.
My Christmas tree's got little chocolate coins hanging from it, so that's about as...
Exactly. Put a fan next to it, watch them spin. Yeah, you know, it's great.
And the top of my Christmas tree is a menorah.
There it
is. Awesome.
You know, totally. Why not? Keep it all together. I don't know what the celebratory situation is.
Oh, I'm sad. I'm sad for you, and I'm sad for pickles.
Yeah. Oh, man.
Oh, I know what it is.
Oh,
go.
Give us an answer.
It is the birthday of the one and only Queen of Heels.
There we go.
My God.
Our queen, who is not here, who is on her celebratory,
on
her tour.
On her world tour.
So,
different countries.
She'll be back next week, and she gave us some big news.
Yep, yep.
That we will share.
Tune in next week to find out all the deets.
Yep.
And stuff.
But we're talking about today, yes. And today's show starts with shotgun story.
Shotgun to the face. No, we don't want to do that. That would be awful.
No.
Probably painful too.
And my shotgun story for next week, if it happened.
Wow. So, hey, how's it going, everybody? Here we go. We're going to do it. If you know what's going on,
no.
This is what we do. Oh, you don't know? Let me fill you in.
Thanks.
We as a group go around the world looking for the wildest, craziest stories we could possibly come up with. We read them off to you, the listener. Hey, how's it going? You get to get involved on The Drain, the Circling the Drain Facebook group page, the CTD Facebook group page. I'm not sure what it's called at this point. Try either one, whichever one sticks. Look for the poll. When you see all four stories, we got four people. I think we got four stories. If we only have three, you're not going to be surprised that I screwed something else up. But we'll have a poll with all four stories up. Vote for whichever story you like the best. Vote for whichever person you like the best. Close your eyes. Just pick one. We need votes. Votes are awesome. Whoever has the most votes wins. Three wins in a row gets to punish the other two suckers. Punishments go up on YouTube. Shotgun stories. Here we go.
There we go.
There it is.
So first thing we have to do, first of all, wow.
Yeah.
That was, if I didn't know what you were saying,
right.
I'd be like, is that the guy from the Micro Machine commercials
sure.
from the 80s?
Yeah, let's hammer out all the details. Well, you know.
First thing we have to do is we have to talk about last week's winner.
Right, right. So you voted for my story. I got one vote. That was sweet.
Actually, you got two.
Oh, two!
Oh!
Two.
And wait. And for some reason, and I will take the blame for it because I put the poll up late.
Okay.
And we got like kind of a low vote count this
week
because of it.
Okay.
But, and you still got two even with the low vote count.
Yes.
So you doubled your usual.
Man.
But the winner was...
Woo! Yeah. Look at you!
There we go!
Look at that!
Because you can't beat a goat or a ram...
Right.
...in a recycling center.
It's true.
So, Mo, as champion right now, you have the option to either read your story first, or you can go last. It's up to you.
Ooh.
Player pass.
Well... I came here to play hard, so I will take that front run.
Alrighty.
Press your luck! Oh, wait.
No whammies, no whammies, no whammies.
Oh, stop! Pickle.
Wah, wah, wah.
Yeah, stop pickles. Go ahead.
Go ahead.
It's all yours.
Oh, I just start to speak.
Okay. Yeah, totally. You're on the button.
Okay. Today, a two-year-old becomes youngest member of world's highest IQ society.
Huh.
Isla McNabb became Mensa's youngest female member at just 2 years old. Here is why her parents got her tested for the organization. By the age of two, a child is typically starting to speak more, maybe playing a little make-believe, probably becoming more independent. While all those things were probably true for Kentucky two-year-old Isla McNabb, she had another feat under her belt at the young age, becoming the youngest female member of Mensa, the world's oldest and largest high IQ society.
So she was menstruating at two?
Wow.
No? Wrong one?
I don't think that gets you into that society. Don't think so.
I'll leave now.
Right. Remember to tip your waitress. Thank you. Bye.
Isla ended up scoring the top 1% of the population, gaining her the top-notch Mensa membership and her parents the chance to gain more information about their gifted children from other parents. The biggest benefits to Mensa is the community, Jason McNabb said. I'm going to just skip right on down.
Not important. Not important.
Not important. Doesn't matter.
Built her own nuclear reactor. No, don't care. Created her own. Oh, go ahead.
Yada, yada, yada. Taking over the world.
She built an interocitor. Yes.
Has a giant long list of genius babysitters.
And then quit to open an OnlyFans page.
Right.
Look at that.
Two years old. Just getting it all done.
Well, I don't even have to finish reading this article.
And there it is.
There we go.
Ta-da. Ta-da.
Now, is it better to have your kid be declared gifted in this case?
Right.
And because now that's what you expect.
Right.
You're constantly, like you have kids, I have a kid. Do you look at them now and go, I don't know, when you were younger, they thought you were a genius and now you're eating paste. So what's going on with that?
Have you ever tried paste?
I kind of have that situation going on.
Right? You so, have that.
Oh, my daughter turned 13, and a demon came.
Oh
yes, basically.
Yeah, so my gifted academically member of the National Latin Honor Society.
Oh, the Latin Honor Society.
Oh, she is. She's very pedantic. It is quite lovely. E pluribus unum in all. But then
carpe carp. Seize the carp.
See that thing on the top of your money? I know what that means.
There you go.
No, she does. She just walks around the house all day speaking Latin. You know, she's casting all these magic
spells.
She's
cursing you out. You have
no
idea.
She cursed herself. Bitch. She's now possessed by the teenage demon.
Oh my God. Oh,
it is the worst thing to happen to my family, I swear.
I was the valedictorian of my elementary school.
Aww.
And yeah, it went down from there. So my parents were like, what you were, and it was, and it was, yeah, I like jokes better.
Yeah.
You know, joke, hey!
It started out good, and then immediately, and
fine, hold on. Pickles, go.
All right, so remember last week when we had the guy who had a chopstick up his nose?
Yes.
Yeah, in his brain.
Ouch.
Oh, yeah, it was bad. So I decided to stick with the theme. It's not as bad, but it's we're going to Spain.
Okay.
And a 21-year-old woman who reportedly swallowed her entire toothbrush.
Oh, my God.
After using it to dislodge a piece of food caught in her throat.
What?
Yes.
She's obviously not a member of
right.
Benzo.
Right. No.
No.
Yeah,
not
no.
At all.
No, as a child, she was declared special. Yeah. She was not declared gifted.
No.
This was not a gifted child. This was a special child. And I should know because personal. You know, anyway.
Okay.
Whatever. He's quite special.
Hyzia is her name. That's all I got here. A woman from Galdacio, Spain.
Right.
Whose full identity, of course, withheld by the media, claimed she'd been eating turkey on November 29th when she began to choke on the dish. Gasping for breath, her first move was to grab her toothbrush.
Well, why is she eating a dish? I don't understand.
Well,
that.
I mean,
it's pretty big.
I mean, it's about as many nutrients as paste does.
So. Oh, okay.
So
I kind of figured that Spain would be current with the rest of the world now that the internet's around and everything. The toothbrush to after a meal is so 1980s.
You would think mints or something,
Doring.
Not toothbrushes.
Well, then again, I mean, they're not even eating their food. They're eating their plates. So what are they doing? We don't know where they're at.
So she tried to first force the turkey down her throat and then just gulp down the 8-inch instrument. Hey, when that happens.
Oh, man.
Hold on. And continue.
She explained that she had to act quickly as no one else was around to help. Yada, yada, yada. It only was getting worse, so I grabbed the first thing I could get hold of, which was the toothbrush, to try to dislodge it. As the moment the turkey became too loose, so did her toothbrush. I tried to hold it by the bristles, and once the obstruction was clear, it just got
Wait. Hold on.
So not only was she using...
Go ahead.
Backwards?
Yeah.
Holding the bristles?
Yeah.
You thought the same thing I did.
Big, gigantic capital letters. Special.
Remarkably, she said she felt no pain during the entire ordeal, which I can't believe.
Again.
Following 3 hours of examination and diagnosis, surgeons were able to remove the dental device during a 40-minute procedure.
Wow.
When she was under sedation, doctors were able to fish out the tool, looping the head of the toothbrush with surgical twine and pulling out. No surgery was required, and she was just glad she could breathe again. By the way, the last thing is, I'm just going to read the beginning of the article saying that she, I'm just going to do this right now, had a toothbrush with death.
Oh.
I thought the brighter side of the coin was she was going to have a scrubbed out colon, but I guess not. Fine, you know.
That's if they had let it go.
It through, you know. Well, it was backwards. So
yes.
Had it been bristles first, maybe we could have just, you know, scrub and bubbled our way all the way through, but because it was all handle and then... I don't know.
No, think about it. If it were to go through the colon, you would want to pull the handle first.
You think, yeah.
As opposed to grabbing the bristles.
That's true.
So.
Yeah.
4 out of 5 dentists recommend going bristle first.
Yeah. 5 out of 5 dentists recommend orally brushing your teeth and not trying to get
10 out of 10
way.
People say, what?
Yeah. And one doctor 20, 30 some odd years ago was just like, yeah, your child special! Capital freaking was special!
Dr. Radford, what's the diagnosis?
Special!
Special!
What was her first name again?
It said Isaiah.
I was really hoping for Special K, but okay. Got Special H. Sean, you mind if I go?
Sure, go right ahead.
Wyoming.
Yeah.
Ooh. We're going to Wyoming.
Woo-hoo. Where everything has tried to kill you?
No, that's not even close. Although this person might want to kill their neighbor.
Oh.
2014, a man named Philip Habeck. He leased a ranch neighboring Patrick Sean Carroll's ranch. So right next door, they're neighbors. Over the past few years, though, Mr. Habeck's cows have been going through the broken fence, and they're on Carroll's property. It's increased to the point that now hundreds of cows at any given time have crossed over to his neighbor's yard.
Right.
So as you guessed, Carroll has grown frustrated with this. He calls Habeck, lets him know. But Habeck's just like, hey, it's no big deal. It's cows. They
move
do this.
Along.
Seriously, they'll move.
Go ahead, hit it. Go ahead.
If you don't like it, why don't you move out of the neighborhood?
Hit it again.
Utterly ridiculous.
Hey!
And there we go. And those are the two cow jokes we know. So.
Yeah, totally, so far.
It sometimes takes Habeck a few days to move his cows back, which makes Carroll very angry. Mm. So he talked to Habeck about it, who admitted, yeah, the fence is old and it's in poor condition. We'll get to it.
Hey, it'll get there.
I'll
eventually.
Put it on my list.
Yeah, it's there.
It's there. Figure it out.
It's right now, not in the budget right now.
Right now, I'm trying to see which end of the toothbrush to use
right,
from a geek.
Yeah. You know.
So Habeck's cattle crossed over again the other day, and the Carrolls were just saying, we've had enough. They were branding their cows that day and decided, we're going to do something to get our neighbor's attention. So Mr. Carroll and his son Tucker and another man who worked for them, they took all the cows,
right,
lined them up, put them into the chute, and quote-unquote, marked them up pretty good.
Oh, boy.
So what does that mean?
Oh, boy.
Well, some of the heifers had penis shapes bleached into their bodies, according to the affidavit by the sheriff.
Right.
The Carrolls are accused of bleaching images of male genitalia and other markings onto the neighbor's cows. I really want to know what the other markings were.
Well, we now know what law of the land is in Wyoming.
Yeah, totally.
And they are now facing felony property destruction charges because an estimated each bleached cow is now worth $600 less per head, and it was $189. Doing the math, it's over $100,000 in damage.
Per head? Really? Yep. We have to say that line in that?
What if they drew two dicks on one cow?
What
if they drew two dicks on one cow? Is that two heads?
$1,200 down the
train. I've seen that video, two dicks, one cow. Don't watch it. I don't recommend it.
Yeah, don't do that. That's just wrong. But,
and by the way, it doesn't say if they were circumcised or not. So,
No, totally. I also think that these guys should be brought up on charges of, you know, like harmful endangerment to the cows or something like that.
Why? They always get branded.
Yeah, whatever. Either which way. But they get branded by the person that owns them in the proper way and everything like that. Not just because a bunch of jerk-off idiots are like, oh, this dick's cows keep getting on our set.
Wait. This what's cows?
I have no idea. I don't even know.
You said this dick's cows?
This dick's cows.
Because that's what they are now. They're dick's cows.
Let's slap some more dicks on this dick's cow or whatever. Like, yeah.
Come on down. We got a special lay. It's dick's cows.
Granted, you could have put a different spin on it and tried to get the fence fixed properly instead of just being whatever. Yeah, okay. Cool.
I agree that the animals should not have been harmed. And I hope that PETA is also involved in this. However, if you're going to tag something up, it was really funny to put dicks on
it. Yeah.
On the side of the cow. Daddy, what kind of cow is that? Move along. Move along.
What kind of cow is that? That's the cow that gets drunk and falls asleep with his shoes on. Remember that. What? You'll learn. College. All right, so
why is my milk look for never mind?
Don't fall asleep with your shoes on.
Sean.
All righty, so California is where we're headed right now because, some stuff went down because a deer statue
Oh dear.
Was vandalized. Oh, was he vandalized? Let me tell you.
They draw penises on them.
They'd be so lucky to have penises drawn on them. A California cabin owner arrived to her property to find a deer statue was heavily damaged, and she checked her security camera to see the footage to see the culprit who did such things to her statue. When it turned out, it was quite an amorous buck who took a fancy to said statue. Dolores Eastman said the deer statue's legs were broken when she returned to her cabin after checking the footage on her Ring camera. A very, very large buck came through, stalked out the situation, tried to get a little friendly. And it just didn't work for some reason. After a while, he lost interest, gave up, and walked away. Just strolled on his merry way.
I think he limped away.
So the cabin owner, left, came back, and wouldn't you know it, the statue was demolished. After checking the Ring camera again, turns out, same buck came back with a little bit of extra vigor, decided to mount for real, mount the statue, when all of a sudden the weight of both deer together just wasn't happening, and they both fell over. One of them broke, the other one got scared and ran off. Needless to say, don't leave your hunting statues outside when you leave your cabin, because other actual animals might be just as attracted to them as you are.
Big buck hunter right there.
Yeah, big buck. Yeah, totally. So,
I was waiting for buck naked line, we got that. You know.
So needless to say, somebody had a quality statue out there. So quality.
Looks like everybody came to play this week.
They did.
Sean, how can people
bring in the thunder. All right, so we just brought four stories to you. Come on over to the drain. Let's try that again. We just brought four stories to you. Come on over to the drain tomorrow. The CTD Facebook group page, the Circling the Drain Facebook group page. One of them will work. Who knows? We'll give it a shot. Try it. See what happens. When you see the poll, vote on whichever story you like. Vote on whichever person you like. Close your eyes and give us a vote. We need votes. Votes are awesome. Whoever has the most votes wins. Three wins in a row gets to punish the other two suckers. Shotgun stories. If you vote for Mo, forces her to come back. Just letting
Does.
You, just putting it out there.
Well, since you're not coming back next week, you said.
I have to attend the Squire Choir.
Right.
The Squire Choir. Does that have anything to do with the Bucks? I can't rhyme anything with that. Pickles will be playing for you then, because he plays substitute. So.
Well, I can't play substitute next week because I won't be here.
Well, in that case,
man.
Hey,
okay.
We win.
Hey!
Okay, we'll figure it out.
Yeah, we'll figure it out.
Yes. Okay, hit transition for me one more time.
No,
thank you. Oh, I heard it. Okay, it's the end of the year, and that means all kinds of awards are given out.
Yes.
Yes.
The latest has been the Oxford English Dictionary, who gives us the word of the year.
Oh.
Does anybody know what the word of this year is?
Buck.
No.
Is there a buzzer, or can I just throw you
there,
out?
There used to be.
There we go. We used to have a lot
we
of things.
We had a buzzer.
Yeah. No, the actual word of the year is, the password is, Riz.
Yeah. Riz?
Riz. Yes.
Who knows what Riz means?
Riz.
No. I know because I listen to the radio constantly. You have teenagers. You should know this. Sean, you're old. You shouldn't know.
No, I was going to say, well, he's a rapper in the Wu-Tang Clan. Is that? No,
not RZA.
That's RZA.
Not RZA.
No, I have no idea what RZA means.
No, from the movie Grease. From the movie Grease.
That's RZO.
Does
anybody else have a wrong answer?
Well, it might be RZ Lightning.
RZ Lightning.
Oh, sorry.
Now I'm trying to think of, like, okay, what other RZs can we
use? No idea.
There's RZO the Rat from the Muppets.
I was going to say RZO Ratso.
Okay. Now, Riz, which comes from charisma.
Oh.
Sean, my friend,
yes.
I would definitely say you have Riz.
Yeah, I ooze Riz.
Riz was crowned 2023's Word of the Year by the Oxford English Dictionary. It's a Gen Z term, charming. Voters and linguistics experts alike. For those who don't know, Riz is slang for style, charm, attractiveness, again, coming from charisma.
Right.
Now, this is how they did, and I had no idea this is how they chose the word of the year. They choose 8 finalists, and then they have votes.
Oh.
You can vote. So in this case, 2 of the votes, Swifty. We all know Swifty, right?
No.
Yep.
No?
Taylor Swift fan.
Fan of Taylor Swift. There we go.
Wow, that's stupid.
Yeah, it's now a word.
Wow, that's dumb.
That beat de-influencing.
De-influencing?
De-influencing. There's influencing and now there's de-influencing.
All influencers should be de-influenced. All
right, so when you de-influence, you're trying to get people not to do shit?
Yes.
Oh.
We need more de-influencers.
Right.
Didn't they try conversion therapy in the past and have it not go so well?
Well, they tried it on Swifties and apparently it didn't work.
Right.
Because Swifties beat the de-influencers.
Right, yeah.
Riz defeated Beige Flag. Who knows what Beige Flag is?
Nope.
Okay.
A cover band of a band from the 80s?
The worst Black Flag cover band of all time.
Hey, everybody.
Oh, my God.
We're Beige Flag.
They play easy listening versions of Black Flag tunes. Beige Flag.
And they do it like, oh, God, what's it? After the boys.
Oh, yeah. Droopy Dog. Sound like Droopy Dog. Yeah, thanks. Remember to tip your barista. We'll be here for the next 25 minutes.
A Beige Flag is actually, you've heard of a red flag. You know, oh, that's a non-starter.
My entire life is all red flag. Yeah.
Everybody I date is full of them.
Same.
I cover them.
Right?
The Beige Flag is, this is just boring about them.
Oh.
So.
Huh.
It's a Beige Flag.
It's a Beige Flag.
Situationship. Then beat Parasocial.
Parasocial.
I don't know, and there's no explanation.
Please tell me that's a conversation you have while parasailing, because I want to get into that. I want that in my life right now. Right now.
You know, I'm parasailing up here, and it looks beautiful, but if only there were... Hey!
You know, parasailing's cool and everything, but you really want to do it? It's those in-depth conversations with some random-ass stranger, let me tell you.
How you doing? Man, oh, it's nice today.
Oh, my God, my ears are popping. I know, we're really high up. This is crazy. Are you afraid of heights? I am now.
By the way, completely out of left field, but... If you had some turkey stuck in your throat, which part of the toothbrush would you shove down your throat?
Hey, those sharks fall in the boat, that's not a bad thing, right? They do that normally, don't they? Okay, all right, just checking.
Cool. Why are we circling and they're getting closer? I don't understand.
I really wish this word would have beat Riz. I'm not really comfortable doing this anymore. This sucks.
And then an average word.
Yeah.
Prompt.
Prompt.
Oh, prompt.
Prompt.
As in timely?
Yes.
These sons of bitches can't get anywhere on time. They're not using the word prompt. They're like, prompt? Screw that. Get it out of here. Get it out of here.
Now, please explain to me.
Yeah.
Prompt beat. Heat dome.
What the hell is heat dome?
Me when I'm out in a summer day and I get a sunburn, I'm guessing.
Sounds like a place for women in menopause to go.
Right?
We're going to. Are you visiting the heat dome this week? Is that what's going on here? I don't know.
Is it like a circle jerk in a tool shed or something? Like that just. Oh, we're in the heat dome now. Like, what?
You know what? I wouldn't use heat dome for that, but there's got to be a term for that, and I can't.
Either way, I don't want to be involved, so I'm good.
If anybody asks you, Riz is the word of the year.
Okay.
Now, we have that. Does anybody want to know who is, take a guess, who is GQ Magazine's Man of the Year?
Me.
Okay, fashion. You came in second again.
Again. Of a bitch.
You were spending all that time in the heat dome is just not helping.
I'm telling you, man. I got to shave more often. Maybe that's what's happening.
I'm going to say Kevin Hart.
Kevin Hart? Okay, that's a good guess.
Right.
Anybody?
I'm sticking
Pedro
with me.
Pascal, maybe?
Okay.
Or Pascal.
He had a good year. Sean, anybody besides you?
Oh, besides me? No.
No?
It doesn't matter. No, I don't know. Pedro Pascal. Why not?
All good guesses?
Sure.
Kim Kardashian is the man of the year.
Nice. All right.
The powerhouse.
How unfortunate.
Yep. The powerhouse mother of four has been named GQ Magazine's Man of the Year, or as they're putting it, Tycoon of the Year, as part of its Men of Its Year covers.
I'm sorry.
So they put her on the cover saying Man of the Year.
Yeah, how Becky Lynch did not win that over Kim Kardashian is beyond me, but okay.
She should win it every year.
She is the man. I mean,
damn, if we could just play that theme right now, that would be awesome.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, I hope that's not because of her performance in American Horror Story, because she's still alive, and I'm still very mad at that.
She is getting more acting jobs because of that.
Because of what?
She's in a TV show right now.
Oh, is she?
American Horror Story.
Oh. I can tell you why she's getting more acting jobs.
Right?
She divorced Kanye? Oh,
no. Because she can swallow a 10-inch toothbrush and not even realize it.
Don't even need the bristles.
She lost a whole toilet brush.
I cut the bristles right off. It's fine.
The reality star is a successful businesswoman in real life.
Oh.
As GQ notes, she's launched two beauty lines. She has several perfumes, an energy drink. Anybody? Welcome. Are you feeling down? Do you need ass? I mean, but I can't think of what to call her energy drink.
Yeah, I guess. Listen.
Let's see. She has a mobile game, a private equity fund, and now she's helping out with, you gotta excuse me, ink on this is
a
very
private equity fund?
Yep. She also has her shapewear visit, Skims, which I saw a picture recently because there is and forgive me for getting this wrong, Swarovski?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
The gem place? Mm-hmm. She has Skims, which is shapewear for women and men. Buy this for your significant other. It's shapewear. She's wearing it, and it's covered in little gems.
Okay.
So you go to give your woman or man, whoever, a hug, mm-hmm. and just, ow!
Right, yeah. Well, there's nothing better than having a bedazzled significant other. I mean, just, you know, from head to toe.
You hug them and you're marking them.
Exactly.
Oh.
You bring them out in the sun, you watch them gleam. It's great. It's totally. I want a bedazzled partner. That's all I'm asking for. Hook it up, Kardashians.
Well, all you have to do is go to a dancing school and join in a little tap recital, and you will get your own bedazzlement.
Huh, yeah. I don't want to bedazzle myself.
I know another place where you can be bedazzled, but it'll cost you $20 each time, but that's fine with that.
I don't want to do that either.
Kardashian spoke in an interview saying it is her work ethic, and she instills that in her children.
Okay.
Does she even know who her children are?
Oh, I'm sure.
Sure.
I know. I've seen show, but...
They're called... my God, how could you even say that? They're called accessories.
Yeah, that's true.
How do you not get that?
and she goes, all right, kid, you see this? This is what we call a trust fund. Don't worry about shit. Mm-hmm. You're fine. You're fine. Don't worry about it. Do whatever you want. It's all good. You're fine.
Stay away from Daddy Kanye.
You're going to inherit this, so you don't need to do this. What's that? Work.
Work. Yeah. You see what those fools are doing? Yeah, don't even worry about that. You're good. You're good.
All you need is a video camera and a willing participant. Nowadays, you don't even need the willing participant.
Some famous, rich-ass parents. You know,
and a toothbrush, and there's your OnlyFans. It's born.
Yeah, totally.
Okay.
Is toothbrush porn some subcategory now?
God, I hope not.
I'm going to check that right now. Not.
I'm not going to look. I don't want that. Nope.
And finally, they just announced Time's Person of the Year. Uh-huh. Now, I'm going to read you very quickly the nominees for Time's Person of the Year. You tell me which one you would vote for.
Oh, okay.
Okay. The annual section, blah, 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 blah. The Hollywood Strikers, the screenwriters and actors who were on strike for almost a year, putting a pause on creating new current content for movie and TV. Okay, I'm going to screw this up. Xi Jinping, which is the president.
Drink. Oh.
No.
That would be
Xi Jinping.
Drink.
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 That's the Chinese president who entered 2023 a few months into his unprecedented third term. Okay, that's fun. Taylor Swift, don't even need to go on. We all know. Sam Altman.
I'm sorry, who?
Remember Swiftie. Remember.
Oh,
that.
Oh, right. The one that football player is obsessed with.
That's the one. Yeah.
Yeah. People doing stuff. Right. Gotcha.
Sam Altman. He made headlines as his departure and then return as the CEO of OpenAI, which has given us ChatGPT, which is taking over everybody's stuff. The Trump prosecutors. Trump became the first president to be indicted in the nation's history. Oh, and now someone who's not even real. Well, maybe now.
Huh?
Barbie.
Barbie.
Oh.
Fans, especially women and girls, flocked to the cinema to see the first ever live-action Barbie movie. Of course, now it's Margot Robbie, and Ryan Gosling is Ken.
Yes.
Pardon me. Could you get that? I just dropped my pen.
His musical number was the best part of that movie.
I still need to see it.
It's very funny. It's very funny, and it's it was very weird experience.
We had a conversation about when it came out. Vladimir Putin. We all know that guy. Mm. He's still trying to wage war against the Ukraine. King Charles III now.
Oh, right. Finally made it to the chair.
That's
right.
Yeah. After his finally, after God knows how many
years. Finally decided to give it up after 283 years.
Fine, I'll let you have 10.
I'd like to see that conversation, though. It's like, Mom, I love you, but are you going to die ever?
Death is literally sitting in the waiting room. He's been here for like 20 years.
Feel like Beetlejuice.
Not as long as you're with that embarrassing saucepot, Camilla.
Seriously.
I'm sorry, saucepot?
Yes.
Oh, I like that.
That's being queenly and proper. I'm so, I'm trying to be royal in Her Majesty's address.
Oh, wait, I'm sorry.
No, wrong one. No. And Jerome Powell, he's chairman of the Fed Reserve, the people who are trying to manage the inflation out there. So after all those nine people, most of which you went, huh?
Yeah.
Who do you think won?
Taylor Swift, because that tour was a beast.
That's who won.
That was it.
Taylor Swift is the person of the year.
Taylor Swift beat out Barbie.
Exactly.
Taylor Swift could be Barbie, for God's sake.
Well, you can't interview Barbie.
Yeah. Not yet.
You can interview Margot
Robbie.
Well, you can interview Margot Robbie, but you can't interview because it was just Barbie that got nominated, not...
Yeah, let that
was just Barbie that got nominated.
Yeah, well, let that AI keep doing what it's doing. You'll be able to have a full conversation with Barbie in about an
hour.
Yeah, don't sweat it. Be fine.
And they also name Lionel Messi as the athlete of the year.
Oh, wow.
So these are the people. Is there anybody who comes to mind who would be like, this person should actually be person of the year? This person should, anybody.
Aside from Taylor Swift? No, not that I could really think of.
Oh, damn. And somebody earlier who I...
George Santos.
According to George Santos, he's already won person of the year.
Can we donate it to Betty White? Did she make it to 2023?
She did not.
No.
She did not.
Norman Lear just died today.
Did he? Really?
Yeah.
101.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Someone else just thought. Oh well, I forgot.
Let's give it to Taylor Swift.
Why
not? Put a nice bow on 23 and let's move on.
Since you can perform on stage for a lot of people,
And you can make all that money in the movie theater too, out of nowhere, because you're just this crazy.
Oh, Sean, I just love it when you hit a transition.
Yeah, and I don't even realize I'm doing it. I'm stumbling over my words because I can't even talk. And just, totally.
Because coming to a theater near you in January, Queen fans will get a chance to witness a concert from the band's heyday in IMAX.
Wow.
Thanks to an upcoming release of Queen Rock Montreal. Remastered version of the concert film premieres in IMAX for a limited run in January
18,
2024.
I'm going.
I'll be right there with you.
I'm totally going. Hell yeah.
Group trip.
I'm down. Let's do it.
Can we get smoothies after?
Sure. Party.
We're already
scheduling.
It's going to be like Rocky Horror, isn't it? Everybody up and dancing?
Yeah, no problem with that.
Let's see. It's been remastered with 12-channel surround sound, crystal clear images, customization theater geometry. I don't even know what that means.
They just put words together.
Exactly. You know what this one has?
Theatrics geometry.
You know what this one has? It has the lumbar Brazilness.
Right. Yes. Yeah. I heard about that.
Yeah. That's a thing now.
You're talking about that on TikTok.
Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I saw that.
Right.
Took a Tide Pod and
created by Bose. It was nuts.
It's a larger-than-life front-row immersive experience. The film contains the footage from two 1981 performances in Montreal. And, of course, if you wanted to see them with Adam Lambert, frontman, didn't you go?
I did.
And?
Great concert.
That's what I've heard.
Great concert. Adam Lambert is a freaking genius musician.
So. If I can ask...
Yes.
How much did you pay per ticket?
Too much.
That's what I'm getting at.
Every concert is just too much. $175,
I believe.
How much?
$175.
$175 because I'm getting general admission tickets. The average were about $280.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
General admission. for that.
Well, I mean, you know, it's, yeah, it's, that's.
Which brings up, especially Sean, who is, well, actually, Steve, you are our resident concert goer.
Yes.
You're at one, like, every month. Of course, there was the Taylor Swift Eras Tour movie, which in 4 weeks has made over $200 million globally, followed by Renaissance, a film by Beyonce.
Yeah, actually, fun. Friday night,
oh,
I went
please don't tell me you went.
No, no. Well, Friday I went to the movies. I went to go see Godzilla Minus One, which was insane.
That I
would
say.
Walking through the theater, because there wasn't too much of a line, so they had the Beyonce movie in, I think, four theaters? And three of which were in the hall that we were walking through, and they all started at separate times. So you heard different Beyonce tunes popping through doors, like as we were walking in. The crowd for that Beyonce show was like everybody was decked to the freaking nines, like ready, like they were going to see Beyonce, which they were, I guess, for you know a certain amount of time.
Well, that's just
it. It was wild.
It topped the box office this week with $21 million in its first week. So now. Like I said, we're definitely going to the Queen movie.
Right, sure.
I'm sure millions of people will go.
Yeah, totally.
Renaissance is now out. You said people are dressing up. We already know they dressed up for the Swiftie tour.
Mm-hmm.
We're always complaining about the price of real concerts now,
right.
Except for Pickles because, you know, he's Two House Steve. But
right.
There you go.
Making it rain.
But is this a way to get around that? If
no.
they're going to put out no. more movies
no.
and we'll go to the movies, it's, won't the concert tickets
no.
start
it's
to go down?
Not,
I
no.
didn't even finish the sentence.
Definitely
and you're both
not.
Going,
it's
no,
not,
no, no.
It's not even remotely close to the same experience, sadly. Like, I've seen live concert movies. Like, I saw Awesome I Fucking Shot That, which was the very last time the Beastie Boys played Madison Square Garden.
Right.
What they did was they gave 30 random people video cameras, and from whatever seat they
oh,
were
nice.
In, they had to film the show. And they made an entire bootleg concert of the entire thing. It was great to see in theaters. It was loud as hell. It was awesome. But it was nothing in remotely close to seeing them actually play live, which I never got to do, which is sad. But what are you going to do? But yeah, like I think it's a great idea. And I think it's
yeah.
going to be a lot of fun. And you can make little events out of it. Like, you know, hey, apparently all four of us are going to see Queen. It's going to be awesome.
Let's go.
You know, whatever. So that's cool and everything. But I don't think it's going to take anything away. I don't think it's going to drop ticket prices. I think everything's just going to be expensive as hell, and we're just going to be crying and broke.
So, Mo, who's your favorite musical artist? I never heard of him. Is he Albanian?
Yes.
Okay.
Totally.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yes.
The Carolinas heard of him.
He's a SoundCloud artist. It's fine. Yeah. Yeah.
I don't know why I drew a blank on that.
Right.
I need like a genre of music.
Rock.
Whatever someone you would
Corey
like
Taylor.
I said
Corey Taylor.
Okay, Corey okay. Taylor. Corey Taylor can't go to a concert, puts out a concert film. Okay, the concert is what was average here? Let's just say $200 for general admission.
Mm-hmm.
Or you can go to the theater, $15-$20, and you can see it. Now, as Sean said, it might not be the same experience,
right.
but you could go pretty much 5 times during the day. Oh, I can't make that concert time.
Right.
But I can make the 4:00.
But you're just watching a movie. I mean,
right.
you know, you got but okay, so you got tickets for the Super Bowl. Or, you know, you could pay for the Super Bowl tickets. Or next weekend you could go to the movies and watch a Super Bowl movie. What do you want
to
do?
I'm going to the Super Bowl
you're
movie.
You're going to the Super Bowl movie?
That's
bullshit. That's different.
You're both bullshit. Shut up.
I want the food coming
okay.
to me.
You're bullshit. Shut up.
That's a little different because
Mo, go ahead.
Going out to a football game is a little bit more of a drag
all right,
sometimes.
Well, blow me sideways for not knowing shit about sports. I apologize. But
do
no,
I don't
have think,
to? Because
yeah.
I really don't want
no,
to.
No.
Who's got the toothbrush?
It's an impossible thing to do. So, you know, that's why you tell people to do it because they can't. So, anyway.
Okay. Yeah. Now I'm willing to just let it go.
Right.
That one just, I completely forgot what I was going to say. Sorry.
Would you go to the movie or would you go to the concert?
Oh, I was going to ask, is cannabis permitted in the movie theater now?
John?
I don't know. I mean, you know, occasionally you'll be sitting in a movie theater and you'll see a random cloud pop up after a while, but nobody smells anything, so I guess it doesn't matter. I don't know.
Okay, does that make a huge difference?
It was a great part of the concert experience.
Okay, it does.
Sure.
It does. Go ahead. It does. Or pop an edible. Nobody will know.
Not the same. No.
I'm working with you here.
Oh, okay. Yes.
You know, I don't want the guy coming down going, "Excuse me, ma'am, the person in the front row is complaining about the smell."
Like, all right, sir. Well, could you not have that weird lisp? Oh, by the way, Trent.
And by the way, can I have a hit?
You need to calm down. Here, bing that real
by
quick.
By the way, how many times would that be if it were allowed in the theaters? Right. So like, no, I'm sorry, we're going to have to confiscate that.
Yeah, sorry. Yeah. Sorry. Gotta take that.
Have to do that right now.
Where are you taking that? Yeah. None of your business.
Yeah, look at the absolute drug den that the break room has now turned into. It's like, oh, man, these idiots brought mushrooms with them. Look what we got.
Putting those on my popcorn.
Concerts are a different experience for me now anyway because I used to do them shit-faced all the time.
Right.
And I stopped drinking.
Sure.
So it's a whole, I need something to make it a little bit more manageable. But the cool thing is, like, when I go to shows that are like Korn or Slipknot or like bar bands, you know, that like we go see, everyone else is my age too. Like, there's no damn pit.
No, not anymore.
Not anymore. We can't move.
We're all passing Advil around.
Because the next day it would be like, what happened? My hip.
Oh, yeah.
Like, my knee.
I went to so many
kids
shows
these days.
I went to so many shows in the early 2000s, like seeing like pretty much everybody. Like, and then a couple of years ago, a friend of mine had tickets to see Slipknot and Lamb of God and a few other people at Jones Beach, and I was like, "Yeah, I haven't been to a show in a while. I'll go, why not?" And I roll in, and I ran into, I saw people that I saw on the scene like from back in the day. Man, metalheads have gotten old. Holy crap!
Oh,
nobody's like there's no younger generation coming up checking out the scene. Everybody's just old as shit. It's just
Well, there's no new deadheads either.
Well, that too. Yeah, well.
Oh, Fish is taking up residency at the Sphere.
At
in
the
Las
Sphere,
Vegas.
Which is just the first step. Let's see what happens.
That's got to be the first concert where it's mandatory to get high before.
Right. Oh, it's always.
It comes with your ticket.
Exactly.
Right, yeah.
It's a scratch and sniff. Don't worry. It'll work.
I'm telling you, that residency is going to be very interesting throughout Vegas. So.
Yeah, they're going to play one song last a week.
More than likely, yeah. Well, actually, no, that's the dead fish. It'll be the same five words repeated 8,500 times for the next month.
If I had five words to repeat over, it would be cake chick is surely delicious. How's that?
Yeah, close enough.
Okay.
Close enough.
And that's exactly what it is. Now the holidays are here.
Guys,
you're going to be visiting people's houses.
Mm-hmm.
And when you bring something, like a good person.
Right.
You have to bring something. They're going to judge you.
They might.
If Pickles brings over, like, here's some deviled eggs, then they look a little runny.
Nope.
There's a toothbrush on the side in case you choke them down.
No.
You want to bring Cake Chick. Why? Because it's going to look amazing. What's it going to look like? Whatever you want.
Right.
If you go to Instagram and you go to Cake Chick 1217, you can see all the designs. Or you can go to Facebook. If you're old like us, and you can go to Cake Chick. You check out all the designs, you contact Cake Chick, give her at least a week's notice, and say, hey, I'm going to this party. You know, she likes butterflies. Can you make little butterflies to put on? Sure.
Sure.
What color you want?
Anything.
Because that's what Cake Chick is all about, giving you what you want. So, can you get gluten-free?
Yeah.
Can you get vegan?
You can.
Sure. Can you get fat-free?
Absolutely.
Woo-hoo. You can get what you want. So now they're going to taste amazing. They're going to look amazing. Let's see if we can help you with the price now. We should give you a promo code.
Well, we got a generic promo code that we give to you all the time because we love to save you money. And that's three easy letters. And those letters would be CTD.
And how much do you save?
That would be 20% off.
Very right. Now, if you were to order more than a dozen cupcakes or more than one cake, see, you can do both of those. We're going to give you another promo code.
Oh,
save
you
even more.
All right.
That one is XMAS.
Oh.
What does that spell?
Xmas, because we're festive.
Yeah, and because Christmas is too long.
Right, yeah.
So use that, and you'll get 25% off.
Oh, hey.
So remember, it's going to taste good, it's going to look good, and you're going to save you some money. It's Cake Chick. Get what you want. Now back to the show.
Progressing already.
Yeah.
What?
Oh, already in progress.
That's the one.
Ah, okay.
You're that so progressive.
Too. That.
Is that a soup? Wait a minute. Someone
Progresso
having soup?
And progress? What are you talking about?
I got a coupon for progressive soup.
I have the chicken noodle. It's very forward-thinking soup.
Saving 35 cents on my beef and barley.
We mentioned gifts.
Woo.
Cake Chick makes a great gift, by the
right.
way.
Yeah.
More and more people, though, are giving secondhand gifts.
Secondhand gifts?
Secondhand gifts.
Huh.
Now, how many hands would they give?
Is it like leftovers from a restaurant?
Yeah.
No, those are called homeless people you're giving that to.
Well, I mean,
that helps.
I mean, that goose made so nicely out of the tinfoil. Why would you want that as a gift? I mean, you know.
You know, nowadays it would be like, here's the food, but I have to take a picture of the goose.
Oh, yeah. Right, yeah, I need a selfie with the goose. Snap, snap, snap.
And I have to put it next to the towel animal that they make on cruises.
Right.
And
yeah,
I've got a whole collection.
Uh-huh.
Who doesn't want to save a few bucks for this holiday season when everything from gifts to wrapping paper costs more?
Yes.
One way that's gaining popularity is gently use gifts.
Gently use?
Yeah, people are going to thrift stores buying stuff online.
Okay.
Or even available free from your closet.
Right. Hey.
There's a company called OfferUp, a secondhand marketplace. Consumers found 78% of people said that they buy pre-owned gifts this holiday season. 51% of shoppers said because of inflation. So I'm wondering, they give a few ideas of this is a good idea to re-gift, this is a bad idea to re-gift.
Right.
First of all, are you okay with that? If I gave you, if I bought a new TV and I said, Sean,
yeah,
I know your TV is 35 inches, just making up whatever.
Sure, from the floor. Oh. Yeah, what?
Hold on, drum roll, please. There we go.
Anyway.
And I bought a 50.
What, it's a big TV? What are you shaking at?
I don't understand.
I don't even know why that was even bad.
You'll have to show me later.
The TV?
Yes.
I haven't given it to him yet.
Oh, well, we got to wait for Christmas, apparently. I'm getting the TV.
Sweet. Well, it is Hanukkah tomorrow. So
oh,
maybe we'll
hey, all right.
Now back to the actual topic.
Right, already in progress.
There we go. I love this show. Now, I buy myself a, what's the biggest TV now? Like a 75-inch TV? Is that a ridiculous
from
thing?
From the crowd.
I think they're like.
Okay, you're out.
I think you can get an 80
okay.
inch before they start going to pull screens.
So
yeah.
I bought the biggest TV
yeah,
I could
totally.
Find.
World's biggest
and television. I go, hey, Sean, I got a 50-inch TV.
Right.
Merry Christmas. Here
okay.
you go.
Cool.
It's a couple of years old.
Right.
It's bigger than yours. Are you upset?
Me? No.
Yeah.
Me personally, no. Because my entire life is secondhand. Like, my entire wardrobe is all from thrift stores. It's
that's
just,
right. I forgot.
That's where it's at. So, me personally, I don't give a damn. Like, you want to buy me some spiffy-ass Tommy Hilfiger sweater or whatever from thrift store? Just wash it first. That's all I ask for because, you know, thrift store clothes got a little bit of a smell to them you don't really want to deal with. But other than that, I'm fine with it. Thanks. I appreciate the effort.
But I wanted my scent on the sweater.
Wait, well, then wear it for a couple of days and then give it to me. I apologize, but I'm going to wash it before I wear it, but you live your life.
Fine. Not giving him the sweater.
All right, fair enough. Keep your damn television, and I'll buy my own fucking
so
sweater.
So Pickles, I give you an 8-inch toothbrush, and the bristles are a little... No.
Which way are you giving it?
Hey.
Whoa. What will your wife allow? Here are a few...
Anything, as long as she can watch.
OnlyFans, now with Pickles.
And toothbrush. Wait, gross. The Pickles toothbrush is kind of a weird
so,
God
okay.
category.
I'm going
if I were to give anyone here
a
pre-used, gently used, sorry,
right.
gift,
uh-huh.
what would be acceptable? Anybody. Like, I gave you an example. TV.
Right.
Electronics would probably be, even if it's like a jacket that
a coat.
Doesn't fit
yeah.
you, but would fit me.
Well, no, you were right. Electronics was actually number
right.
one.
I'm going to say gently used kitchen appliances.
Sure.
You
air
are.
Air fryers, stuff
right.
like that.
Correct. That is number four.
Right.
Gently used. This
on
is
the
a
list.
Weird term. It makes used. It kind of weird.
Although here's
yeah.
an interesting one. Under it's under housewares. They say, by the way, if you have an unused candle,
oh.
give that to someone. I'm like, well, isn't
I mean,
that the gift you give to someone when you don't know what to get someone?
Right. Because you've
candle.
Gotten those gifts because
exactly.
people didn't know what to give you. So now you have a gigantic vanilla candle that will burn for 5 years. So you give it to somebody else because you don't know what to give them. So you're like, hey, do you like the smell of vanilla? No, I don't. Well, Merry Christmas. Here you go.
Didn't I give it to you 3 years ago?
You did.
Mo, I'm giving you a sweater and a candle. Don't put them together because I didn't. That explains that burn hole right
Oof.
There.
Yeah, yeah.
Man,
you're not
you
getting
take
that wax.
Everything fun away from me.
Right?
Yeah. Toothbrush? No?
You'll have to show me later.
Okay, wait. No, I didn't hit it. Okay, so we got electronics. We got housewares. Three other things on the list? Two of which...
That's where it's clothing.
Clothing.
Clothing is not on the list, actually. No. Oh,
probably because of the different sizes.
But again, if I saw...
Yeah.
Sean, if I saw a Beastie Boys vintage concert t-shirt.
Yeah.
And I went, oh my God, I've got to get that for Sean. Sure. You'd be fine with that.
I would. Absolutely. Okay. Yeah.
So if I bought it and gave it to Pickles, would you be okay with that?
I would be impressed. I'd be like, wow, that's really cool. I hope you appreciate it because that's awesome. Like, you know, I wouldn't be jealous. I wouldn't care. It wouldn't, you know, ruin my day or anything like that. But I would definitely be like, that is really cool. You better appreciate that. Because if not, I'm going to rob you.
Yeah, by the way, when do you do your laundry and where?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Just want to know. How do you feel about beanies? I mean, nothing else will get taken except for that t-shirt, and I might be wearing it next week. Just saying.
Just leave it on the side. I don't want you to go through your clothes. Yeah, listen, I just want to make sure that it's the first thing
it,
in
just
there.
Leave it on top. I'll walk your dog. It'll be fine.
Mo, how would you feel about this? Now, your kids are a little older now, but when they were younger, if someone brought over toys, perfectly good toys, especially when they're younger. You know, would you be okay with that, or would you be like, so used?
So no, goodness no. As long as there's not like some nefarious alteration made to it,
right?
You know?
Don't ask about that brown stain over there, though. It's fine.
Yeah, why was there a dick on this toy all of a sudden? Yeah.
I meant more sharp and pointy things. All
right,
perverts.
Right.
Have you met the show? Wait a minute. Yeah. So number one is electronics. Number two is toys for children. Number four is housewares. Number five, I'm surprised no one got. Wine, liquor, everybody's got.
Right.
Oh, we have that thing tonight. Right. I have nothing. Grab a bottle of wine.
Yeah.
What was number three?
Number three, you should know.
Oh.
Number three is an item suitable for anybody. It's what you get someone when you don't know what to get them.
Toothbrushes.
Gift cards. Yes.
A toothbrush for a gift card. You are correct.
A magic eight ball. No?
That's under toys.
Oh.
You got to rewind. Gift cards.
Okay.
Because everybody has a gift card that they don't even, I forgot about it.
Right.
I'm actually carrying one in my wallet. I went the other day. I'm like, where's that card?
Yeah.
Why? I have a gift card?
Yeah.
What's that from?
I got a bunch of them. I mean, it's easy. Like, and it does come in convenient, you know, handy every once in a while. Like, you know, all of a sudden out of nowhere, you're like, I don't have to pay for Taco Bell. This is great. Like, you know, it's just gift cards kick ass.
Okay, now they give you the five examples of things you shouldn't give used.
And a loaf of bread.
Toothbrush is not on. Can you put soup in it?
Slightly
I mean, maybe
warm.
You ate out the middle and then you pour it
on.
I want some Progresso
bowl.
Soup in there.
Slightly worn Wonder Bread. I've only made two PB&Js. Merry Christmas.
Wait. Did you take the butt ends? Because I don't like those.
Oh. No, I didn't.
Ah!
I will remember that for your birthday, though. I apologize.
Okay.
All right. Now, would you be a better person to give them the PB&J sandwiches instead of just half a loaf of bread?
How many of them are there?
And you have to make sure that they don't have a peanut allergy.
Oh, shit, that's right. I forgot
a
about
penis allergy?
Things.
Wait, what?
Now, that's the cow.
Oh,
the cow
oh that's the cow.
I have a penis allergy. Right. Can't be anywhere near him.
Oh, man.
I know, right?
It goes along with the nut allergy.
No,
I mean,
exactly,
it's right there.
Exactly.
Right, anybody have any guess what not to give?
Use underwear.
Use underwear. Believe it or not, on the list.
No.
Undergarments.
Ew.
Used undergarments.
Ew,
do not give those.
Because people do. They donate like their lingerie.
Yeah.
Don't give it.
Hey, buddy, I know you're a fan of Rick and Morty. Just mind the streaks. Like, what? Oh, you nasty son of a...
We had
I'm
a story
moving.
A few
I'm
weeks
moving.
Ago of, I want to say Finland.
Right.
Where there's a thrift store where they are telling the entire town... Stop donating your used sex toys.
Oh, yeah.
We don't
want
them anymore.
Yeah.
Speaking of, number four on the list.
Right.
It is not.
Yeah. You can't return those.
Yeah.
You know what's on here? Cookware. I would appreciate if someone gave me like a really good, this is an amazing pan.
Right.
I would appreciate that.
But I also have gotten to the point in my own adulthood where I've had like the cookware where nothing matches. I have four lobster pots. The one good saucepan I had is missing a bolt. Like, I've been at that point.
You
got to
hold it at a certain angle.
You
so
would
it
appreciate it.
Yeah.
No, it doesn't even have a handle. You got to get the oven, the glove, and lift it up and put it over here. Shoes.
Used. I don't want somebody else's sneakers.
I agree.
No, definitely not.
I'm thinking, how do you know the size also?
That too. I mean, you know, well, like, Yeah. I mean, there are certain things. There should be certain, like, kind of pieces of information that you could just randomly ask somebody and they don't need to know. Like, you, what's that shoe are you? It's like, why, you buy me sneakers? I may at some point. I just need to know. Like, I mean, you guys bought me a hat for my birthday. You bought me a fitted hat. You needed to know the hat
and
size.
And I asked you.
Exactly. You were like, what's your hat size? I was like, I don't know. Let me check. Okay, now I'll forget. And like 3 weeks later, hey, I got a hat. Cool. Like, you know, whatever. But there are certain things that people should need to know. And just when they ask you the information, just give it to them.
Well, here's something you really don't want to receive. Okay. And I've got to be on board with this. Steve?
Oh, no.
Uh-oh.
You just don't want to give Steve to anybody. He can't go to anybody. His wife might be upset.
My wife has tried to re-gift me. That worked.
Any time. And brought you back to the manufacturer. Right. It didn't work.
Yeah. This is defective.
How would you like it if you got... Let's see. You are you're a Giants fan, right?
Uh-oh.
Okay. So I get you a personalized Giants jersey. And on the back, it says, Tim. No Giant named Tim.
He's not changing my name to Tim. That's for sure.
Don't give anything personalized that was already personalized.
Oh.
These seem like common sense answers, by the way.
Yeah, yeah.
But I know you're a Giants fan, so what?
So, you know,
can't be Tim?
I mean, granted, it's got my last name on it, but I figured, you know, it's got their name on the front. So
we're
your
brothers anyway.
Yeah,
it's good.
Yeah, totally.
I love you like one.
So, Mr. Chin, you're just going to have to wear that at the back of your jersey.
I got no problem with that.
You're a Mitsu. I don't remember him playing for the Giants. What's going on here?
Nope. Every year we do this, and every year we try to guess the 12 days of Christmas.
Oh boy.
In real life.
Due to inflation.
Mm-hmm, exactly. Now, this year, if you bought all the gifts from the 12 Days of Christmas, if you don't remember, 12 drummers drumming, 11 pipers piping, 10 lords leaping, nine ladies dancing,
8 maids a-milking, 7 swans a-swimming, 6 geese a-laying,
5 golden rings,
4 toothbrushes,
3 French hens, 2 turtle doves,
and a bird in a tree.
And the line we have to sing so many times.
In real life, it's actually higher than ever. Oh. It would cost you an estimated $46,729.86 to get a lot of birds, apparently.
Damn.
To purchase all the gifts in the classic English Carol, according to a company, PNC Financial Services, who has kept this record for like 40 years.
Mm. Right.
So this year is a 2.7 increase from last year. The first ever, like I said, about 40 years ago. It was about $20,000, so it's gone up 133%.
Goodness. Birds are expensive.
Mm. Well, now we're going to play our annual game, which is now that you know all 12 of these, because you just recited them. Again, one toothbrush will not be that expensive. And a can of soup.
Right.
A can of progressive soup.
Hey, listen. All you need is some progressive soup to get you where you got to go.
And a can of minestrone.
Hey! I'll give him that one. Out of those 12, which is the cheapest and which is the most expensive?
All right.
Wait. Okay, I have a question. Are we actually buying the people, like the drummers and the
pipers? You're renting them.
We're paying them to play, paying them to leap, paying them to dance, whatever they're doing.
And it's not like, it's just one of each. It's not one per each day. Like, it's not exponential.
Yeah,
What's
the most expensive out of the 12? Mm-hmm. What's the least expensive? I'm going to say the least is number one, the partridge in the pear tree.
Okay.
That's probably wrong. And I'm going to say the most expensive is the Piper's Piping.
Okay, you have that the least, and you have Piper's Piping.
I think that was my exact guess last year. That was totally wrong. So maybe it's right this year. I don't know.
It could be.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, and you're getting most. Okay. Mo, what do you think?
I'm going to say the 2 turtle doves are the cheapest.
Okay.
And the 9 ladies dancing.
I don't know. I can get that for $20 a pop down at the Shady Lady.
Depending on what time of day you go, too. All right.
Oh, that lunch shift is just brutal, man.
Man, 11 a.m. at the strip club.
All right, then should I switch it?
You can if you want.
It's totally.
Then I will make the most.
Just because I wrote it in ink doesn't mean it's permanent or anything.
Scratch
it's
it
fine.
It's fine.
I get to change my mind. It's okay. Right? I will say that the most expensive is the partridge in the pear tree itself.
Huh. Partridge and a pair of threes. So what he said was, oh, I like what you're doing there.
Right.
He's
right.
always wrong.
Starting to learn.
So you
Starting
have to get
learn.
It right. Yep. That's most. And pickles, what do you got?
I'm going to go the four calling birds is the cheapest. And I'm going to
Come
go
here, bird. Come here.
Why don't you pick up? I call you all the time and you're not answering.
It's the phone plan that's the expensive part.
Hello?
Why do you go on Boost Mobile all the time?
Why don't you just tweet me?
If you got... Oh, give her the ring. you know, that's what you get for being on Cricket. You just
ate
it.
Oh, boy. Okay,
what's the most?
10 ladies dancing.
10 ladies dancing. Well, are you paying for another lady?
Yeah. Exactly.
10 more ladies dancing.
Oh, so he's got 20 ladies dancing, which isn't in the song at all.
Oh, wait, I'm going the ladies dancing?
It's
nine
or 10 lords weeping.
I'm
going to
go with 10 ladies dancing. That doesn't exist. Okay, give me 20. If it's going to be non-existent.
I'm going to double down.
I'm going to go with
Is this on DraftKings?
Let's just make it non-existent. Let's just make it non-existent and expensive. That's how I like it.
Okay.
10 lords weeping.
10 lords leaping is the most expensive?
Yes.
Okay, you're sure now. Because I've already written it down and then crossed it out.
Yeah, 10 lords leaping.
Positive.
Okay. So let's go down the list. The actual cheapest, because you're only paying for, I'm guessing, less than an hour.
Five gold rings?
No.
Oh, okay.
8 maids of milking.
Oh.
You could pay people minimum wage to just, hey,
always forget
you
about
maids,
them.
Get over here.
Yeah.
Boop, boop, boop. Okay, you're done.
That's
Let's
sad.
Go.
Not 58. The Handmaid's Tale.
You know,
$58. Did you say Handmaid's
Tale? Not the Handmaid's Tale maids.
Well, you're getting
those
their hands.
Expensive.
They're getting their hands.
Gotta be honest. The milk, the ladies milking, they should be making more money than the ladies dancing. It takes a lot more effort to milk a cow than it does to dance.
Have you ever done it?
What, milk a cow?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a pain in the ass.
It's not that bad.
It's better than dancing. Yeah, well, I...
Well, that is how I dance, though.
Listen, it's the only way I make
I'm
money.
Very white.
Like,
oh.
Whatever. It's fine.
What milking you don't
cows?
Know is it's
exactly
the same,
yeah, yeah.
It's the same cow and they all get a turn at the cow. It's like, right. All right, 10 minutes are up. You're up next.
I milked that damn cow before I realized it was a bleached penis and nothing was coming out.
It's the worst Christmas ever. I can't believe the next 12 days I had to milk these cows.
I would be like opening up my door, going, more birds
again.
Birds again.
Birds.
God, what's going on here?
I'm allergic to feathers, you sons of bitches.
Curses.
That's
so
it.
That down pillow I got you.
Bad news.
It says pickles on it.
Bad.
Do you still want this?
Nope.
Coming in next, Sean. You guessed this was Lisa. You weren't that far off. Mo, you said this was most. One partridge in a pear tree. $319.18.
Still pretty expensive for a bird.
Well,
a tree.
For a bird in a tree.
Well, at least it has a habitat.
It does.
And eventually we'll get some pears. So that that counts. Mm.
Yummy.
Coming in next for $330 is 3 French hens.
Huh.
Hello, via hens.
Drink.
Drink.
Yeah, coming in next would be 4 calling birds.
Hello. Hello. Hello.
Straight to voicemail again.
Damn. Man. Damn. Well, they're always pecking at me, so, you know, I just can't even be bothered. It's got to, you know.
Coming up next, those 6 geese laying, and if you're, I don't understand that, because if you are in Long Island,
right,
they're just everywhere laying.
They're all over the place. They're
6
like
geese are shitting.
Yeah, they're
ow! On my new shoes!
Yeah. Now, all these damn geese out here, it's like a recreation of Abbey Road every freaking day on the streets. They're just walking
boom,
slow,
boom,
like,
boom.
It's like, I get it, you're the walrus, now fucking move, I gotta get to work.
Coo-coo-ca-choo.
Exactly.
Turtle doves for $750.
What's a turtle dove? Is it a bird?
It's a turtle.
It's got to be.
It's a turtle?
It's a turtle with Dove soap on it.
Is it?
Yes.
Awfully clean. Very, very clean. It's cleanly. All right.
Hello there.
Well, I guess you don't have to worry about salmonella from them. They're already soaped up.
Aww.
No, seriously, what is a turtle dove? Is it a bird?
It's a bird.
Oh, it is.
It's just full of birds.
Yeah, yeah,
thing.
The Christmas birds is what this song should be called.
It would be way cooler if it was like sharks.
Right?
Ooh.
Nope, we have to rewrite it now. So,
5 golden sharks.
So when
hammerheads.
I like that, actually. I'm wondering, they were sitting there thinking, okay, so it's a partridge and a pear tree. Okay. What's next?
Right.
Two turtle doves. More birds?
Okay.
Okay.
Sure. Where are they going? I mean, the partridge
what's three?
Has a tree.
What's three?
French right. hens.
French hens.
Where the hell do they go?
So more birds. You know, Bernie? What? I don't. What's with the birds?
I mean,
I don't know.
I mean, honestly,
what are you,
like,
what are you doing?
Everybody likes birds. Look, they sing.
Okay, okay,
it's
okay.
It's nice. They can wake you up in the morning.
Okay, okay, okay.
Let's go with, I'm pro bird.
Now, what's number four? We need four now. What
Falling
are we doing?
Birds.
Bernie!
More birds.
More birds?
More birds.
These are the birds that can communicate.
So, but
the next words out of your mouth after five better not be birds. What do you got?
Right, we're going to do golden rings. Let's just do golden rings.
Well, you got to pay everybody off for throwing all these birds at him for a while.
And
so Bernie, like,
and Bernie's sitting, and Bernie's sitting there going, I'm going to sing golden finches.
Right?
Just
yep.
me.
I am telling you guys, birds is where it's at.
Okay.
This is never going to catch on.
Right.
We're going to, I'm telling you.
We're going to get canceled. It's going to fly away from us.
It's a movie.
Oh. Yeah. It seems bird brain to me.
Right.
Why are your feathers so ruffled?
There but, we go.
Bump, bump. Oh.
And parakeet. Okay.
And
parakeet. No, you can tell. That's why they do the five gold rings.
Right.
Because they were just looking at him because everything's birds. And they just go, five gold rings. You got that? We're not doing birds. We're not doing birds.
Fine. I'll just put it in there just to make you happy.
So the gold rings are, five gold rings are $1,245.
All right. So five gold rings. Okay. It's day six. What do we got? Six geese. Oh, you son of a bird.
I hate you.
Fine. Fine. 2-7.
Right. Right.
You better.
Swimming.
Are you kidding me? We have one comfortable bird. One comfortable bird in a goddamn tree. Every other bird is scampering on the floor. They're laying around. They're just doing their own thing.
Do you expect us to clean up after them?
Yeah, seriously. And you think five rings is going to help all of this?
But I'm telling you, this is what the hipsters are into these days.
They're into birds. You
know? They harvest the feathers. They make their kombucha from it. It's good.
Fine.
All right, fine.
Then we're up to eight.
I guess.
What bird now? Yeah. Parrots? What are we
you
doing?
Know what?
Pterodactyl.
Yeah, totally.
Where are we going to find them?
Guys. We need to clean up the bird shit. Let's get the maids. But they have
Fine.
To be milking. They have to be milking.
How many do we need?
Eight.
How?
Eight maids and milking.
Wait a minute.
Milking?
How?
Lactating?
No, wait.
What about the people who are lactose intolerant?
Listen, this is 1904. We don't have to worry about any stupid lactose intolerance here.
Was it
not even invented yet? I don't know.
Okay, back to this. The most expensive, let's see, six geeselings, $780, seven swans of swimming, $13,125.
Yeah,
but that's not the most expensive.
Right.
Let's see, we have nine ladies dancing for $8,308.12. Drummers drumming.
It's an awful lot of singles.
It is. $3,468. I could get like 12 middle school kids and just bang, bang,
yeah,
bang.
Yeah, but are they really...
Yeah, quality.
Like those kids, you know.
You know what? I'm paying for quality because I need you to drum and get those birds out of here.
Yeah,
just scare them away.
Yeah. Little do you know, drums attract more birds.
Mm-hmm.
They do.
Piper's piping.
Right.
$3,207, and the winner, the most expensive, 10 lords a leaping, $14,539.20.
Man,
that's an odd number per.
It is an odd number.
Per lord. By the way, you are a lord.
I am. I'm not very good at
lord
leaping.
Lord Radford is in the house.
Not very good at leaping.
Will
though,
you be leaping? Yes. Can you find nine friends and will you be leaping
I'll
for
give it
us?
A shot. I mean, like, I don't know any other landowners over in Scotland, so what are we going to do? I mean,
we could find
a
few.
Hey, listen, you can find eight others or whatever. I don't know. How many lords are leaping?
Ten.
Ten lords? Ten. Fine, give me nine more leapers and, you know, it is my year, so why not?
Leapers like the ones where the parts are falling off their body.
No,
totally.
You take a leap and you lose a finger?
Right.
Yes.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
10 lepers leaping.
What? Leapers
leaping. If you're Jewish, it's 10 lepers schlepping.
Right.
Five golden rings, but there's no fingers for
the man.
And we're still going to have a pterodactyl.
I think we should rewrite that song.
With a toothbrush.
With a tooth.
Oh,
and a toothbrush to get the turkey out.
Oh, man.
Okay, guys.
Yes.
Hit that button for me. Of course we should play a game, and it's Sean's favorite game.
Oh, man.
Sean, what's the name of the game?
Sunshine State. Or someplace else?
No!
Damn it! What's the title?
Sunshine State.
Or Other Place.
Or Other Place.
Or Other Place. Sunshine State or Other Place.
And those are the rules.
Yes.
All you have to do is I'm going to read you
if
a story.
I can get the title right, and that's the game.
That's the game.
We just sit here and we keep asking, what's it called? And I get it wrong because I'm an idiot. And there it is. And that's how the game works.
No. Yeah. You're special.
Right, right. All capitals. All capital letters. Yep, yep.
Uh-huh. It's a very simple game.
I'd wear a shirt, said it, so everybody knew.
We've been doing this show
that
forever.
That was their reaction most of the time. It worked.
I know, it's like him again.
Oh, son of a bitch. Yeah, how many times is he going to walk in on the wall today? Okay, good.
Give him a helmet. Yeah, he'll be fine.
Just throw another bird at him.
I had a few. Anyway.
Yeah. Oh, God. That's where you get the hammerheads.
I mean, windows are just so tasty when you lick them. It's fine.
They're clean.
They are after all done. Anyway.
Capital letters special.
Exactly. Yes. All capitals.
Yes, we do know. We've been playing this game a long time, and we've been doing a lot of stories, and most of them come from Florida.
Okay? Yeah.
So we're going to pit Florida against the entire world.
Okay.
I'm going to read you a headline and a little bit of a story. And just based off of that information, you're going to have to tell us, is it Florida or is it another place? The Sunshine State or another place?
It's other place.
I know, but he was
you
on a
screwed
roll.
Up.
He was on a roll. And to see how this starts, Sean, I'm going to start with you.
All right.
Okay. Husband linked to domestic sausage battery.
Huh?
During a verbal altercation, Ray Allen, 61, not that one, allegedly threw sausage, presumably pork, at his spouse. The said sausage links hit the 64-year-old, and this is my favorite, victim, no name.
Right.
Victim.
Right, right. Yeah.
On the right side of the face. Ow! Okay, EMS workers responded to the couple's home, washed the victim's eyes out with a saline solution. Allen was arrested for domestic battery and booked by a county jail. They did not take the sausages in as evidence.
Well, thank God.
Yeah.
I think these two are going to be linked together forever.
Oh, boy. Boy.
Oh.
Yeah, salt with a deadly protein.
Oh.
I'm going to say someplace else.
You're going to say someplace else?
Yeah, I don't think they're slapping each other with sausages in Florida.
It's Florida.
Damn it! All up in the face. Just slap, slap, slap.
Come on. It's old people. Old people doing silly things.
That's true. Florida.
Sausage fight.
Right. Yeah. All right.
Okay, Mo, you all warmed up and ready?
Sausage party at the retirement home.
I'm all ready for that sausage party at the retirement
home. Oh, well, if you like this, if you like that, you're going to love this one.
Mm-hmm.
Your headline is, a lewd act done atop a dead marsupial.
Oof.
Oh, well,
here's the story.
Oh,
Rudy Wilcox, 45, was observed defecating on a deceased possum with his pants lowered and his anal region exposed. Probably had a toothbrush, right? It took place in full view of the motoring public during busy traffic times. It was also observed by an officer. After being read his rights, Wilcox just said, "One me." He told the officer,
"It was
you. You said somebody else." So, did this take place in the Sunshine State or any other place?
Oh, and by the way, officer, you mind if I tag in this TikTok video? Because it's going to go viral.
I think if he was pooping on a marsupial, he may have something viral.
Marsupial.
Yeah, oh, boy. Listen.
Hit it.
Marsupial.
They saw me pooping on the road again. It wasn't me. Anyway, I'm going to say someplace else.
Someplace else. No, it was Florida. Two in a row.
That's so Florida. It has to be Florida. Right?
Guy came up to him and just said, "Officer, I was playing possum. What do you want?"
That could have been a West Virginia.
It could have been.
Yeah. Poopsum? Wait, possum? Poopsum? Okay, never mind. Couldn't do it. Okay, you ready?
I have to just get the image out of the last story out of my mind.
Okay.
Yes. Okay, go.
Your headline is Inflatable Santa Claus Gunned Down by a Drive-By Shooting.
Oh, wow.
Donald Nelson and his wife were sitting on the couch watching TV when they heard a small bang. And then she asked me to go take a look. When I looked at the front door, we saw our inflatable Santa had fallen over. The giant blown-up Santa they just bought for $200 had been gunned down in a drive-by. The unfestive act left a gaping hole in Santa, but with the help of a nimble-fingered neighbors, which are the best kind.
Right, yeah, yeah.
Santa was stitched up and rose again. Aww.
Okay,
fun. I love a happy ending.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Totally.
Great, I decided that now I get a gun down Santa as the next image of my mind.
They didn't gun down the reindeer. Maybe they were shooting at all the birds. They were like,
it's my Second Amendment to take fire at Santa.
If that bird calls one more time and then hangs up, that's it.
I was going for the portrait of the pear tree, officer.
I missed. But I ended up pooping on a possum.
I'm going to say this is Florida.
No, it's Kentucky.
Sean.
Three.
Yeah.
Let's see. Pick a number, 1, 2, or 3.
3. 3.
Okay. Oh, you're going to love this one.
All right.
Attorney suspended for tossing a poop-filled Pringles can.
What?
I didn't get that flavor of Pringles, but...
I don't want that flavor of Pringles. Usually that happens after I eat Pringles. Anyway.
Do you want sour cream and onion or number 2?
Oh, man. Oh. Gross.
Yeah. Jack Blakesley, oh my God, they have his name. Oh my God. Has been suspended as an attorney for a year for tossing a poop-filled Pringles can into the victim's advocate parking lot. He claims, "I'm not targeting anyone, but I have a habit of defecating into Pringles cans and randomly throwing them from my car."
Once you pop into a Pringles can, you can't stop.
You pop, you just can't stop.
I bet you can't throw just one. He chose the Haven of Hope parking lot, as in, I hope I don't get hit by that Pringles can.
Hope somebody finds this and thinks it's actually Pringles.
Hey, this is a personalized gift. I made it myself.
You ever accidentally reach in and think you got your hand stuck? Nope, I'm good.
He gets a thrill from pranking victim advocates that he know he's going to be in the courtroom with 15 minutes from now. For those who can't see, Sean just brought up a can of Pringles.
It's empty.
Oh, thank God.
She's got the Pringles. Somebody was just eating Pringles. Just so happened to work.
Wait.
Somebody was eating Pringles.
Right. We hope it was Pringles.
Should we leave that behind for Tony for tomorrow?
Oh, yes.
Oh, right there.
Who wants to poop in the can? Oh, okay.
Get that can out of here.
He admitted to throwing the Pringles cans filled with his waste from his vehicle at least 10 times so far in a variety of locations because it helps me blow off steam. I don't think it's steam.
He was blowing off steam.
Gross. Man.
So, Sean.
Yeah.
Was this in the Sunshine State or any other place?
He's not allowed to be a lawyer for only a year?
Only a year.
Only a year.
Yeah.
All right.
What gets you fined?
What?
Golden rings.
Right, well, first.
Dang, hit it.
All right. Well, first off, I'm going to say this is not Florida. This happened someplace else. But I have to, could you just imagine him being your lawyer and going, listen, this case is lost. We're definitely going to lose. You're not getting this. However,
I have a
you
law.
Have an idea.
Brown versus lawyer.
How we can
lawyer.
Get that back.
Brown listen, versus lawyers is my
how
precedent.
Do you feel about Pringles? Do you enjoy them?
Yeah.
Can you finish a sleeve?
Yeah.
Can you finish a sleeve quick enough?
How quick?
I 10 minutes, 15 minutes.
Yeah, sure. Especially the small cans.
Yeah. Nope. We're going full-size can
here. Oh, big
here.
Can. Big
yeah,
can.
Fun fact. Pringles are a diuretic. Do you know what happens afterwards? We use that can for more than one reason.
We're going to hit the judge with it.
No. We're going to leave them right on the porch of the offenders. We can light them on fire if you want, but that is illegal. That they may not stomp on that. It's not the paper bag like it was in the 80s.
Is that
going to
help me win my
well.
Case?
No, not at all. This actually might cause another case. Possible. However, I've gotten barred twice, so, you know, third time's a charm, I may be done. But we're going to give it a shot, so let's see what happens.
It's okay, because I brought my toothbrush to clean out the area when I'm done.
Right.
Fine.
Yeah.
And you said this would take someplace else. You are correct.
Fantastic.
Yes. Took place in Ohio.
Oh, man.
Don't go to Ohio.
Oof. Wow.
Mo.
Yeah.
Let's see. Man tried to steal a Waffle House tattoo.
Wait, what?
Here's the story.
Right off the arm of the waitress. Come here, sweetie. Ah.
I thought that was the QR code for the menu. Hold on. Meet Max.
Meanwhile, what's a QR code?
That depends on where. Yeah. Meet Max Alexander Krimjek. He's 33. He was reportedly under the influence.
At a Waffle House? Never.
No.
Never.
Krimjek again?
He went to the tattoo parlor and demanded a Waffle House logo tattooed on his right calf.
Okay.
Came time to pay for the tattoo, and he went, nope.
Wow.
Yep. They offered him all kinds of ways to satisfy his debt. Hold on. There we go.
Yeah.
Do you own a Pringles can?
Right.
And a toothbrush.
Yeah.
When it came time to pay, like I said, he refused. The police then came and they frisked him. He has $6 and a driver's license and nothing else. For getting a tattoo and leaving, he's charged with theft.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's on his body. He still pleaded not guilty.
Right.
Ah.
Genius, I say. Wiley Coyote. Wile E. Coyote, super genius. We don't have it anymore. Sunshine State or other
places? That sounds a little too high class for the Sunshine State, but...
Wait, that happens?
But it's a Waffle House tattoo.
I was going to say. So that you just, call Waffle House high class?
So it's definitely down south.
Well,
then,
I'm saying it's more of a financial crime than it is so much a bodily harm crime.
True.
Right, yeah.
So, you know, no alligators were harmed in the making of this, no Pringles cans.
True.
I know a lawyer he could get in Ohio would probably take the case.
Yeah. Well, at least about a year or so from now, but yeah, he'll take the case.
So I'm going to say it did happen in the Sunshine State because I'm rooting for you, Florida, to be a little bit classier than you present yourself.
Yeah. You are correct! Yeah. Okay, Pickles, if you get this right, you're 500. If not, you lose. Your headline. Do not call 911 about your stolen drugs.
What? I think that's the first point in time you're supposed to call 911.
Lily Rinker is 23. She opened up a Pringles can and was surprised. No.
You know how difficult it is to find acid? These sons of bitches. Call 911 right now. Hey, four sheets. They're gone.
She called 911 to report that a male friend she met last week. Oh, okay.
Right.
Stole her pot. She explained that she had $30 worth of pot in her grinder,
$30?
And after Carlos left, there's only half a gram.
Yeah, because they got high on their...
So she called the police to discuss where Carlos... There you go.
Right.
Yeah. Rinker was questioned by an officer who determined... You're an idiot.
Yeah.
No. She has a pair of open arrest warrants, so she's off to the hooscow.
Right. Special!
Yeah,
special!
Capitals. Someplace else.
Well, not your pick.
Next Tuesday. What?
It is.
Firework!
Firework!
Firework! Sex toy. We play a game called Sex Toy or Firework. That's on July 4th.
It's our annual 4th of July game.
Oh, I'm so disappointed it's not the Christmas game.
Well, we don't...
Christmas balls or... Oh,
right.
Okay, never mind.
I'm going to say this is not Florida.
It is Florida, the Sunshine State. Pickles.
Oh, man, I would have been wrong, too. See, you should have listened to my bad answer.
Ah, damn it, that's right, I forgot.
Man, I was trying to help. I actually knew it was your question. I was trying to help.
Yeah, it's all right.
By giving the wrong answer.
That brotherly
transition.
Love thing, man.
Oh, okay.
Last story of the show.
Yay.
Who here now? I know we're getting more smart things. Does anybody have a smart car?
No.
No. Would you ever get one of those driverless?
The driver's not even intelligent in my car. Come on now.
You would get one?
Oh, sure.
And you like do your nails, take a nap, you know?
Sounds good to me.
Yell at your kids, get a toothbrush, whatever, you know, while you're doing that. Well, they have smart toilets. You might not want to get one now.
Right. It's going to tell you what's wrong with you?
Is it just a Pringles can? Right.
Definitely. Because once you pop, you can't stop, of course. Yeah. Now, they do, by the way, they do have smart toilets that will analyze your deposit.
Right.
To tell you if you're healthy or not.
That's actually not a terrible idea.
You should be eating more cruciferous vegetables.
Exactly. Uh-huh.
Yeah, why does it look like a horror movie when you're done? I don't understand.
Your fiber intake is terrible. Oh, my God.
You need to drink more water.
White Castle again? What is wrong with you?
Man. You need to stop muling cocaine.
By the way, a little more, please.
Did you eat Taco Bell last night?
Yes.
And this morning, and this afternoon, and actually right now while I'm sitting. Totally. Just in one.
Do not flush that goldfish here. I don't care if he's dead. Don't do it. Don't
do
it.
Do you want to play a game?
Damn it. What's it called? Number one, or I kill you. No.
Okay, smart cars.
Smart appliances.
Yeah. Smart appliances. Gotcha.
Are all the rage, even for stuff we definitely don't need to be smart, like a toilet.
Right. Mm.
There are downsides to some of these things, and a man in China found out the hard way while using his smart toilet.
Does it remind you to put the seat down? Is that?
Oh, that would be nice. Maybe it does it by itself.
Is it self-cleaning?
Oh, that's even better.
That would be even better.
Right?
Yeah, can of Coke does that.
Right?
He first sensed that something was wrong when he smelled smoke. But again, Taco Bell. Then he saw plumes of white smoke coming from the toilet bowl.
And he instantly thought, Taco Bell.
Of course.
It's like, never again.
He said, my smart toilet's a bong.
That means a new pope is coming, actually. Right?
That's not the smell I'm used to. Hold on.
No.
Am I at a dead show? What's going on here? That's when he got off. Oh, well,
I
bet people.
He did.
That is the toilet, then.
Oof. That's it. Didn't even mention the toothbrush this time. Just then, before he could pull his pants up, the toilet exploded.
Whoops.
Nice.
And started burning. Oh, I've had those days.
Oh, my goodness.
What happens in Vegas stays in Vegas.
Listen, just give a new meaning to blowing up the toilet.
Hey!
So there it is. There it is. Did you do it or did it do it on its own?
Thankfully, he wasn't hurt. It's unclear what started the fire. I think that was Billy Joel.
Right, yeah.
He didn't start the fire. But the man thinks it may have been sparked by a short circuit.
Right,
I'm still going with Taco Bell for that.
Yeah, and the explosion scared the shit out of him, too. Thankfully, he was already on a toilet.
It scared the shit out of him, and he was in the right place.
In the right position.
Oh, wait, no.
Oh, wait, hold on.
Hold on.
Carolina.
Oh, Carolina, who's not here, doesn't know. Okay, explain what Carolina might not have known. Okay. Or Mo? Is there anything that Mo didn't know?
There's quite a few things that Mo doesn't know.
That we were
in the show?
In the show, not necessarily in life.
Not just life, we don't have time to decipher all that.
There are definitely things that I don't know.
Right.
But from the show, is there anything Mo didn't know from the show?
From the show
today.
A week ago?
Right now. We just did a show,
anything
by the way.
Anything to be explained.
I don't know if you knew this.
I would like to be explained, please.
Yeah,
I don't know if you knew this, but
explained is not a word.
I don't know if you know this. We record this, what we did.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't sign off on that.
Other people can hear it.
Man, yeah.
Other people can hear it?
Other people can hear it.
They're going to hear my sweet Fran Drescher voice?
Right? Mine too.
You know who would love that? Carolina.
Oh, man.
She says she knows everything about Judaism from watching The Nanny.
Yeah.
I feel like a lot of people know everything about Judaism from watching The Nanny.
We just did this entire show.
Yeah. Mm.
Is there anything that was mentioned in this show that we just did?
Mm-hmm.
That you didn't understand.
Why
are you asking me this question? That's all I need to know.
Why are you asking me this question?
Why put me on the spot?
Because we have a bit called Carolina's Corner, and it's everything she doesn't understand from the show.
Okay.
And then Sean, in a comic way,
tries to explain it because I make way too many in-depth references and stuff that she doesn't understand, and then all of a sudden she's like, what is this? And then I explained it there.
Beastie Boys? Who
yeah,
are they
who are they? What is that about? So
they
it's
fought for
fun
your right
thing.
To party.
Yeah,
yeah!
Exactly.
Do we think Carolina would know who the band Queen is?
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah, the band Korn. You mentioned Korn, and you mentioned Lamb of God.
Yeah.
Do you think she would know
that? And Black Flag, by the
Black
way.
Flag, Black definitely Flag, definitely not. Black Flag is a punk rock band from the
But
from
I bet she knows Beige Flag.
She probably,
she might,
probably yeah,
does.
She probably knew all of those together.
Does she know Droopy Doug?
No!
Probably not. Probably
okay.
not. Yeah.
Carolina, yeah. we wish you
wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy
back.
New Year.
Happy
and,
birthday.
We'll see you next
happy
Tuesday.
Birthday.
Happy
Wednesday.
Birthday.
Yeah.
And that song. That,
the wrap it up music.
Yeah, that her boyfriend created, actually.
Yeah, yeah.
For us. Thank yeah. you, Fernando.
Shout out, Fernando. Good job.
Yeah, Fernando.
So, I guess it's time to say goodbye to all our company.
It's
do you want?
That.
Do you want birds?
Birds?
No.
Do you want birds accompanying you?
No, no,
birds?
No.
I got
killed.
All these birds. Somebody's
I've
got to take some of these birds.
I've already killed two turtle
doves. Ah.
The one.
But,
well, in that case, plug away.
All right. We do a YouTube page. We have a YouTube page. It's called Circling the Train Podcast, and we put up full shows, the full shows that you'll see. Not only on the Governor's Radio podcast YouTube page, you'll also see them on our YouTube page. We'll link that to our socials. We also put up bits from this show every now and
just
then.
Little bits, just
little
bits.
Little bits if you want.
Bits
and we also put up...
With you.
With
every
yeah,
week.
We also put up punishments. And,
she's crushing your head.
When we do that, we will put up punishments.
Squeak.
We put up
pinching
punishments that we're going to eventually do, and we'll put them up on YouTube. I also do a sports show. It's called On the Clotheslines / On the Sports Lines. And nothing will probably be going on until the year-end show that we'll do the last week of the year. So I'll be on more to talk about
that. You know what's really amazing about that is,
yeah.
and I'll bring in the year-end facts, but we are in way more countries. We're in, I think, 48 of the states. There's still two states that haven't
God,
downloaded
man.
Us.
Who hasn't downloaded
Delaware?
Us?
No, I think Delaware is okay. But... And a whole bunch of countries, and Sean keeps saying it over and over. There's somebody out there who's learning English from us.
Me.
Oh.
And I'm waiting.
We
some,
apologize.
There
no,
is some guy out there in Germany right now going, on the clothesline. It never shows up.
What is this?
Why do they keep saying
it? Trying to get the grass stains out of my football jersey. It's crazy.
It's not working.
And football is soccer there.
Football
so
is soccer there. I almost said soccer, but I was like, wait,
no,
nope,
you got
sports
right.
guy. Sports guy.
Good Mo, job. Do you have anything to plug?
On Monday night, you can catch me at the Avenue in West Hempstead. Show starts at 8 o'clock, I believe.
Nice.
Yeah.
Yep. Information's on my Facebook page because I don't have any other social medias.
Right.
So that's about
And what
it.
Is your Facebook?
Mo Melts.
Mo Melts. Well, if Carolina were here, she would tell you to go to Instagram. It is Circling the Drain Podcast, and go to hers, which is the Queen of Heels.
So The Drain is a place. It's a place on Facebook. It is our Facebook group page. You should go over there. You should go over there a lot. You spend a lot of time on there. Post some stuff. Give
Here's
us some,
stuff.
Funny things. You know, help us out. We're trying here. Maybe you can put in a little effort. Nah, don't put in any effort. You be the fan. We'll be the talent. So head on over to The Drain tomorrow when you got all four stories up. Vote on whichever shotgun story you like the best from the beginning of the show. If you don't know what we're talking about, go all the way back to the beginning of the show and re-listen the whole damn thing. It'll be
now,
even funnier. Because
we circle the drain.
Because
so.
You can circle back. So there it is. So vote on whichever shotgun story you like the best. Whoever has the most votes wins. Three wins in a row gets to punish the other two suckers. Punishments, like Pickle said, goes up on YouTube. We're all over the place. We're a podcast. Podcasts can be downloaded everywhere. And the places you can download this podcast are...
Oh, if you don't know, how did you even get here?
I have
My
no idea.
God.
I don't even know.
I'm going to plug our TikTok. Remember, we've got that to go on there. We've got plenty of videos. You guys seem to like them. I have a challenge for everybody now.
Cool.
Based on something Mo said.
Okay.
I want everyone to go to The Drain and rewrite the 12 Days of Christmas.
Oh, boy.
Ooh.
Can't use birds.
No birds.
Use whatever animals you want.
Anything
no
but birds.
Birds.
Anything
but
birds.
Birds. But bum.
For God's sakes, no more birds.
Son of a bitch.
So we do want you to do that, and we do want you to go to Instagram. Why? So you can check out CakeChick1217. Go to Facebook.com/CakeChick, and you're going to get the most amazing cupcakes and cakes. Get what you want at CakeChick. Remember to use promo code. If you're ordering a dozen cupcakes, it's CTD. You get 20% off. If you want more than that, Congratulations. Use the promo code XMAS, Xmas. You get 25% off. So, Cake Chick, get what you want. For us, we're going to be back next week.
We will.
The Queen of Heels will be making her triumphant return.
She will.
She's got some amazing news that we will share with you.
She does.
And that's about it. Anybody have anything else to say?
Do you guys want me to come back?
Yeah.
No, we want you to come back.
Well, you got it. You got to do.
No, some... I'm sorry. The song ran out, so no, we can't.
Well,
no.
Well, you got it. You got to go to the Crazily Paisleys next week or whatever it is.
The crazy
guy going on. So that's a thing. But
the choir.
So when the Crazily Paisleys is all said and done, you come on back any Wednesday. You know where we're at. We got chairs. We got microphones. Come on through.
We got Pringles cans and poop.
Seriously.
We're fine.
Yeah, we weird really stuff, don't. You know.
I want to thank you, though, for
coming
in
absolutely.
The past 2 weeks.
Past 2 weeks have been fun as hell.
Definitely.
We appreciate you. Thank you so much.
You fit in. You are part of the family.
Exactly. You enjoy our silly, which is always good.
Or is it, in this group, is it like step family? Is it,
ish.
You know,
yeah.
We're sort of
yeah.
like, we're the oddballs.
The second family that you don't actually tell the first family about.
Right. You guys were totally that lunch table that I didn't sit with.
Right.
But after school, I would hang out with
afterwards.
Because you had to get high to do
exactly.
it.
That and somebody needed to explain to me what was going on in that comic book store because Yu-Gi-Oh!
Right.
I don't know
totally. So.
See, we have a use.
Yes.
We do. We are very useful.
So remember to get your toothbrushes.
Yes.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
You are special.
You are.
Special!
Capital letters.
And remember, if you give us a chance,
we'll give you a laugh.
Bye.